Maybe.
Almost.
Maybe we're live?
For real, we are.
I wonder if we're live in all the places that Keenan has promised us to be.
All the places.
All of the places.
We're there on the YouTube.
That's what
he
says.
We're there on the Facebook.
The books of the face.
I've been there.
I've been there once.
Oh, there's an extra voice in here. What is that?
What?
That's so weird. This thing says it's been live. It says live 45 minutes.
That's
that
crazy.
Makes me nervous.
Wait, how many voices do you hear?
All of the voices.
I don't want to tell you because
yeah,
we might freak
all.
Everybody out.
Might take a doctor and a family member. That's all it takes. And they lock you up.
Right? You
Come
have to enjoy
again, and they just
the
won't
voices.
Let you out.
It's silly. You have to enjoy voices of other people. You're allowed to enjoy other people's voices. Why can't I enjoy my own?
I gotta get out of here. I gotta get out of here.
I don't know. I just wonder what's going on. We got a minute and 10 seconds before something happens. Is there anybody I think we should share it? Probably a good idea. If you're hanging out right now, if you're into good ideas and not bad ideas, first of all, what the hell are you doing here? You're confused.
I think it's a great idea.
Maybe we're live. Maybe I didn't turn my I don't even know. 52
party
seconds.
Foul. Party foul.
I fouled the party. No. These are true. These are things.
We're in a giant
it says
party.
We've been
of
live
one
for
right
an
now.
Hour, bro. I have
That's
no idea why it's
right.
Said that.
Over here it says live for a minute and 12 seconds.
I have no idea. But we're going to be live in 30 seconds. I should probably, you know, get my poo in a groove.
Grew it up.
You know what I mean? You know what I mean? It's kind of cool. We got a friend hanging out today. James Martin's in the house.
James Martin is
hey,
in the house.
That's me. That is me. Hey, I'm James Martin. How are you guys doing?
He's Martin.
I am.
Yeah.
I mean, technically, my dad was adopted by a Martin, but I guess I should have been a hassle. That was my dad's original.
You were a hassle.
Officially. Yeah,
what
I
heard.
I was a hassle.
I heard
seven,
you were.
Six, five,
four,
three.
Who counted?
One.
We did it.
Go.
We did it. We're live. We are officially live everywhere. And have been for like 2 minutes. Welcome to On the Rise, guys. How are you doing? Welcome to the show. Hope you're having a great day. We are having a fantastic time. We have a lot of great... Today's going to be a different show. It's going to be a different kind of show. We've got James M. Martin. Maurice is in the house. He's going to be painting today. And we're going to learn a little bit about what he's got going on. He's painting to the music. This guy goes out and he paints at live shows. We have a few friends that do that sort of thing. And it's fantastic. What a great addition it has been to all the live concerts. And if you haven't seen or been part of that, then you're about to be. So you might as well hang out and do your thing, my friends. If you're just jumping on, be sure to hit the share button, guys. We're trying to get out there and into the world of all of the internets and all the good stuff. And we're hanging out right here in beautiful Brown County, Indiana, and that is in Rainwater Studios. That is ran by a guy named Keenan Rainwater. And
hi, guys.
Usually he's a big old jerk, but today he's been mighty kind. So I'm going to try to keep things that way by not pressing the envelope, as they say, sort of things. But welcome to On the Rise, my friends. We're going to make music. We're going to feel good. Today's message is, every day, there's an opportunity to have something new or do something new. And today is no different. Or is it?
Or is it,
right? Because we're doing something new today. We're spreading all the good stuff, my friends. Now, we need to get to know James Martin just a little bit before we just let him go willy-nilly in the studio with his... his paintbrush. But I bet right now... Oh, yeah, I bet you didn't think... Is that you used the camera you're going to use on James? You used it on me, didn't you? There,
I did,
Keenan.
But look, and I'm fixing
now,
that right
yeah,
now.
Yeah, yeah. I noticed. So this is.
You going to say hi to James?
Camera.
Is that what's up?
Three or four would have worked. Three would have probably been a good one.
Hey,
I don't know.
Don't second guess
I'm
me,
just
Russ.
I'm just trying to tell you how to do your job, Keenan. But this right here is our friend. This is James Martin. How's it going there, James?
It's going very well. I don't know where the camera is.
Now it's over there. It's over there in the corner now. There you go. You're close.
Oh,
there,
you there
it is. Hey, guys. How's it going? Yeah. After all the time we spent to make sure all the lighting was correct, Keenan went and screwed you, dude. That's
right.
What he did.
Boom.
That's what he did. Welcome to the show, everybody. So we're going to have live painting today during the show. But, James is a lot more. He's an artist. He's more than just a live painter. He's also, he was telling me a little bit about, tell me, James, about what you were telling, tell myself and everybody else here on the internet a little bit more about what you do. Maybe we can bring up, the Indie Walls. Tell us a little bit about what's going on in Indianapolis.
So what I got going on with Indie Walls right now, I'm talking to anyone that'll listen because we don't have anything like this in Indiana that I'm aware of, that I've ever seen. But essentially it is an artist-owned and operated artist gathering space that has studio spaces where we create and share art. It's free to go into. It's free to look at the art, and every wall has art on it. The outside of the space is free walls, which means you can come down and spray paint whatever you want on the walls. The owner of the building gives you permission.
Nice.
And we'll say,
it's
come
always good
on
to get
in.
Permission on those things.
The interior walls, we ask that. I've always got permission. Well, even on the outside, if you're going to paint something, you know, don't paint over anything fresh that's brand new.
Yeah.
Let things age a little bit. But absolutely, create art, share it. That's what it's about, being able to express yourself as a creative. And if you have any passion to where you are like, I want to create art, but I don't have the money to do that, come check out Indie Walls. Have a conversation with us. We want to find a way to help you get what you need in your hands to be able to create your art.
There you go.
And we're also going to create events. And this is a venue at this event where we're going to have events at this venue, Indie Walls, to show your art, to
nice.
Share your art,
and
to
this,
sell your art.
This isn't a very popular site of Indianapolis with the Fountain Square area.
Yeah, it's just
you know,
outside
lots
Fountain Square.
Of art going on in Indy these days. It's been pretty fantastic, and I'm excited to see what happens with Indie Walls as I've been learning about it, and I think it's pretty awesome. So any of you artists out there, come into Indianapolis, even on vacation, make your way over to Indie Walls.
Absolutely.
And paint some shit. Put some out there. Give you some of that love and some of that good stuff. Now, I've also learned that James is a very intuitive person. Intuitions. He has
stronger.
These things. He's feeling what? Yeah, he's feeling the artist and deep within himself. And he knows. It sounds like you know that guy very well. Sounds like you know that guy very well. Not all artists. As we go through life, we go through devastations and we go through traumatizing. I believe a lot of art is produced as a form of creativity and expression through trauma and through hard things in life. And sometimes it's not always that. It's not always that.
No.
But I know that as a young man of 41, that surely you've lived a lot. Life, right?
Yeah.
You've had your ups, you've had your downs. You're telling me a little bit about where you would get in the dark space and it was hard to create and all that stuff. And we should, I say that because, there's a lot of people hanging out right now that could take us some good advice when we're feeling really down on ourselves to say, hey, you know, this could be a phase. This is something that, you need to cope and you need to get going. And one of the great things you can cope with is art.
Yes. You know, for me, art took me from the darkest space I've ever been in. And I've realized that it's a great method for anyone who's stuck in either depression or grief or whatever it is that's keeping you locked in this space where you're like, I'm not good, I'm no good, I'm a burden to people, I'm just going to stay right here and do nothing. That is a voice that is not telling you the truth.
Mm-hmm.
You are worthy. It is okay to not be okay. And realize that, sit and really think about that. I say, no matter how I'm doing, it's okay to be right where I'm at. And if I want to get out of this, I just have to go do things. And you can do things. In fact, you can do anything you want.
Right.
You can do anything. The only thing stopping you is your belief that you can't.
Isn't that sad? But it's true.
Is. It's so strong.
And I think that we all fight that.
I think
that it's something that's like one of those life things that happens in it, for sure. For sure. So it's like, when, you know, that's great advice, James.
Thank you.
It's great advice. That's right. I'm somebody that did the same thing with my music and my things like that. It was my expression. And you go through those dark periods where you're like, I don't know why. But right now, I just feel like I just want to give up or I'm not where I thought I would be. And the fact is, you've been working on it. So you got to give life the chance to show you what you've been working on, too, once you get there.
Life is soul crushing at times. And you've got to make sure you find ways to cherish these moments, even if they're little wins in your day, cherish those moments because that will help you get through the moments when you're like, what am I doing? What have I done with my life? You can go, you know, actually today I actually did this. And the more you can really celebrate those wins, I feel like it's easier to combat those negatives.
Right. That's true, man. That's true. We all need to hear it sometimes. We all need to act on it sometimes. And sometimes it's easier said than done. And these are the things, one of the things I liked what you said earlier, James, was you were talking about how you wake up every single day and you got to get through your nightmares to enjoy your dreams.
Yes.
And you got to go and face the stuff that you don't like, things you got to get over the hump every single day. And we should know that, like, that's okay. But, you know, don't wait all day to get over the hump. You know, try to get it out of the way. Get that stuff worked as best you can, as soon as you can. Shake it off and try to get yourself working. Now, shake it off, it could be a terrible term because, you know, I'm not so sure everybody here is as big a Taylor Swift fan as I am.
Really?
I'm just kidding.
I thought everybody loves Taylor Swift.
Yeah, they should. Yeah. And they should shake it off, right? We used to have this thing, wiggle it out. We wiggle it out sometimes, you know. But you got to get yourself giggling and feeling good. Guys, this show is going to – it will lead to music. All right, it will lead to music. I just think we should get to know our artists a little bit better here as well as we're coming out there, my friends. And I think we need to get our good mornings and all the good stuff started. So I think right now the best thing to do would probably be, Keenan, can you officially start the show that's already started twice?
Let's do it.
All right, let's do this.
Ladies and gentlemen, from Rainwater Recording Company here in Rainwater Studios in beautiful Brown County, Indiana, we present On the Rise with none other than Mr. Russ Baum.
This guy.
That guy. Russ has been over there in the dark, chatting, saying obscene things. You don't even know how this morning has started. Russ comes in here all wild and crazy in the mornings, and you're just lucky that I tame him down a little bit before he gets started. Here he is, Russ Baum.
I will not be tamed by no Keenan Rainwater. All right, guys, how's it going? Welcome to the show. Happy dang, what is it, Wednesday? Did we make it to Wednesday?
Dadgummit,
we did it. We did it. We got Robbie Reich hanging out over on the YouTubes, as well as the, who else we got hanging out over there? Charlie Price and Josh Venice. What's up, guys, over there in the YouTube world? We got our friends hanging out. It's time for our good days and good mornings. It's good days to you. excuse me, I got a cough. Adrian Parker, good day to you. Jennifer Geddes, happy humping into you, she says. Happy humpy humpy day. That's what we got going on. Let's see, and I hope that everybody who needs it gets to hump today. Michael Rhodes, good to see you, buddy. David Yule, Nikki Woods, nice to see you. Let's see who else we got chilling. Travis Dillery's in the house. Thank you for all the tags coming in there. I see all that. Make sure you're tagging in your good buds. Jen Williams, welcome to the house there, Jim. Hope you're having a great day. Courtney James, she's another fantastic artist. How are you, Courtney? Nice to see you. Sarah Walmsley, welcome to the show. How are you, Courtney Sturgis? Love Live is good. We got Johnny G. Great to be here. It'd be great if you were here, too. You know, as in, like, in the studio, Johnny, because, you know, I dig you, dude. How's it going, Web Web? Nice to see you. And Laura Bowden's in the house. All right, guys. Now's a great time to share this, share these things out. Oh, 200 stars. Johnny G coming. He likes the compliments, Keenan.
Thank you, Johnny G.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Thanks for those stars, buddy. We appreciate it. Guys, I see Charlie Price is saying he wants to hear some Grateful Dead. Well, here's the thing, guys. Today's going to be a different kind of show. All right. Now, we're going to have live painting during the show. So what we're going to do is I'm going to play a set of music that I've got laid out. There's a, you know, John was talking to John. I'm sorry, James. I saw Johnny G's name down there and I called you John, James. I'll call you John from now on, James.
That works.
Or Wiener. We went with the Wiener. Is that what we wanted to go with?
Yeah.
Tim Redner, Aaron Ludwig. What's going on? So nice to see you. Make sure you're sharing that post out, guys. We got something super special today. So make sure you're tagging in people, all of your artist friends, all these guys. Now, James, who have been the most recent handful of bands, or if you want to, a couple bands out there that you have painted on with them during their performances on stage and things?
So Indica is usually who I paint with. They're the greatest band that I've ever heard.
You solid. Love some Indica. Nice, yeah.
Second, Meager Kings. I don't know if you've heard of them.
Yeah, we'll take that.
They're pretty awesome. Off the top of my head, those are the two that stand out.
All right, we'll take that.
For a couple others.
All right, we'll take that. We'll take that. All right, some Dakota Mucky in the Trip, maybe something
yes,
like that.
I think I saw you do that. Dakota yeah. Mucky. Yes.
Yes. Excellent. See, excellent stuff. Now, in case you didn't know, performance painting is a thing, guys. Performance, because that's what it is. It's a live performance.
Sure.
You know, that's a lot of people. You haven't been out to concerts in these realms of things. You're gonna see a lot. You're gonna see artists out there, and they're part of the show. They're part of the music. They're part of the vibe. So here's what's up. James just isn't gonna paint stuff that is random stuff. What he needs to know how you're feeling today.
Yes.
Right. Let him know how you're feeling today. We're gonna give him some notes. We're gonna give him some notes as we go. So this is a collaboration painting.
Yes, absolutely.
So we're gonna need you guys to just let him know. And he says we operate on feelings, right?
Yes, absolutely.
All right,
cool. Emotions drive the art.
Yeah, go ahead and tell us a little bit about how you feel about that. Like, because guys, I really need you, James, to talk with our audience here of amazing people. Now you're dealing with all awesome people here. So go ahead and communicate, if you will, just a little bit, and let them know what your, you know, kind of how you flow on it. And I will try to keep up with some of the comments as they come through to let you know.
So which part do you want to know about? The actual painting process? You want to know
Right now we're trying to, let's see, you guys want to know how you're feeling, and you want to give them some ideas on the kind of, tell us what you're going through kind of stuff, or how, you know, what's up, you feeling great, it's good to feel great, good to feel whatever, you know?
Yeah, I think it's important to, even if you're not feeling great, I should say, even if you're like, no, I'm just not feeling it today, that's fine. You should focus on that and create art using that. You don't have to always be in a great mood and feeling good, and today's rainbows and ponies.
Right.
You know, it's okay to be angry in paint. I'm actually working on creating a room at Indie Walls where we do rage paint. And you can come in and throw paint at stuff and
nice.
Create art from it.
Rage paint.
It's important, though, to be comfortable with your emotions changing and not thinking that that's the end of the world just because I have this emotion or that emotion. It is telling you something, and you can work on it. But I feel creating art based on your emotions, tapping into the intuition to where if I... Like, when I'm at a concert and there's bands playing, the music helps me paint, but also, yeah, how the people feel in the crowd, it seems to somehow tell me what to paint. I don't understand it, but I'm seeing it happen in front of me over and over, and I can't help but to tell people about it, going, this is pretty cool. All the artists at Indie Walls, like, everyone that comes through, I'm like, have you ever done live painting? Because this is a pretty cool process as an artist. It challenges you in ways that you normally aren't challenged. Like you wait until, well, at least I do. I wait until the music starts for me to even have an idea.
Uh-huh.
And so I don't even know what I'm going to paint until the music starts playing. And you just tap into that intuition. It gives you a color. The music tells you which direction to go. It's hard to put into words, but it is a vibe.
It's that intuition, right?
Yes.
Is what you're talking. The intuition.
The intuition tells you, try this, try that.
And you can get triggered with ideas as you listen to conversation, as you go on with life, you know, sort of things like that, you know. So I figured, I thought it was kind of neat. So the fact that whenever you described how you do that, it reminded me of whenever I collaborate with another artist.
Yes.
And then I was, sorry, I don't know what's going on here. My computer.
Russ doesn't know what's
going
on.
Yeah, it's a fact. But anyway, whenever I write songs and collaborate with other artists, I typically will find myself, listening to them and kind of adding words they're saying into the songs, and basically just going with the flow of what they're saying, and without really telling them that's what I'm doing at the time, sort of thing, you know, as in kind of way to create and take the moments and just kind of roll with it. Now, a lot of times in writing music and stuff like that, the words also come very similarly the same way whenever you just kind of roll with whatever's really kind of popping off and standing out around you and things like that. So I picked, for this, I got a small set of music prepared. James, he says it takes him about 25 minutes. He could finish off a pretty good painting in about 25 minutes, which is amazing considering, look at this thing, is empty canvas, ladies and gentlemen. So I had put together a small set of songs. These happen to be songs that I wrote, except for one, and one is special because you said you sing it every day. Yeah, we'll definitely put some soul shine in there. But I went ahead and prepared a small set list, which is rare for a guy like me. I usually don't prepare set lists at all. Glenn Adams, nice to see you. Jay Acton, nice to see you too, dude. Thanks for dropping in here, my friends. But we're about ready to do a kind of a set of music, kind of nonstop, so Keenan won't have to jump up and down from his desk to take off my reverb and stuff. He's got this special button that makes me sing a lot better than I sing really, okay. You know.
That's
it's a dirty trick, right? It's a dirty trick.
This is not true. You know? I just put you in a different room. A different room for you to sing in.
I put you away to the side and hide you in a bathroom and sing in there, sort of thing. But guys, James, after we get done with his painting here in the next 25, we're going to talk a little bit more about what some of his passions in life are. He's got a passion for artwork. He also has a passion for philanthropy and helping out others and realizing a collection with other people can go really far. He's a part of, what is this, a Canvas for a Cause?
Yes, absolutely. That is the nonprofit. Which is Indiana Members Foundation, and so we started this program in 2014 that it basically was started to give honor to my mom, Joan Wolfe, and the Joan Wolfe Legacy Grant for the Art.
How amazing.
Yeah, and it's a wonderful program that they essentially, when they first brought it all to me, and they were like, hey, we want you to teach these paint parties, essentially, where we raise money for Joan Wolfe Legacy Grants for the Arts. I had not painted in over a year because after my mom had passed, I just stopped creating. I was in a very dark place, and I only wanted to create for her. I wanted to impress my mom. And when she was no longer here, I was like, I have no reason to create. And it just gutted me. And when they gave me a purpose to paint, and it was honoring her, I was like, I got to figure this out. Even though it takes me over a year to finish a painting, I'm going to somehow paint it in 3 hours or less. And so I just binged watched some Bob Ross.
Yeah.
I realized, wait a second, I'm overthinking this. And when I realized I had a process I didn't even know about, which was getting rid of expectation, just sitting down, plowing through a painting in one sitting, and don't pick it apart at every single step. Instead, keep moving. And I realized when I do that and I apply it to life, it digs me out of depression very quickly. I had a purpose to live, and it was honoring my mom. And at the same time, I was painting again. I was no longer the artist that didn't create art. All of a sudden, I was able to help people. It went more from the grants thing for just my mom. It went moved on to other nonprofits that we were able to reach out to and help give money to. And it just, yeah, it opened my eyes going, wait a second, I can create art and help people? Like, that just blows my, not just nonprofits, but the people who came and paint. They would then come up afterwards and be like, you know, these little philosophy quips that you throw in, you're right. And it made me think about this. And then the next time they'd come back, they'd be like, you know, I started thinking about what you said. And I realized that the things I say when I'm helping people paint are helping them get through their dark time, because it's helping me get through my, but it's not just me. It's everyone. And I hope everybody could come join one and listen.
Yeah. See, that's like it's a therapy, isn't it?
And for
it's,
sure.
It's a life. It's just an awesome thing. I love your story and how it came back to you. And, you know, one of the neat, important points to me in that story is the fact that there was a moment, where you had gotten so far into belief of that you were just the artist that can't create anymore.
Yeah.
And unexpectedly, because you were given an opportunity to give it a shot, and you had kind of, you know, there was a moment where you went from that artist that could not create anymore to the artist that was creating more than ever.
Yeah.
And, you know,
that's me right now.
And people should know that in their journeys, you know, don't give up on yourself, because you, as soon as you get that energy to do it and you take your opportunity, you can turn it all around.
Yeah.
Amber Lynn Hurley, she loves you. She says, what's up, James? How you doing? She's stoked
Hello.
That you're here. Karen Lee is hanging out, too. I see we got a lot of friends of Jay Acton throwing you a little bit of artsy-fartsy up there. Lauren Reeves, how's it going? Nice to see you. Nice to see you. Yes, Jennifer Geddes, this is going to be awesome, I think. I think it's going to be awesome, James. I feel like maybe it's time to go ahead and get to work, James, as we're going to do this thing. Now, if you guys have any suggestions about how you're feeling or anything like that, James likes to work off of your vibes out there. So if you're typing things into this comment section, I will share them, okay? So as long as I can pull it off, you know, that sort of thing. Now, now, all of these songs that I chose, I started this. These are all songs that I had written with co-writes with everyone or with other people, or in the idea that I was picking up on someone else's vibe and taking kind of, you know, the intuition performance as to how these songs were written. So I'm going to go ahead and roll with this set here, James.
Okay.
And I'm going to bid you. I don't know what you do there. You just say on the count of, you know, on a four count. It all starts, I guess. But yeah. we're gonna start this thing off with this is gonna be Marigold. All right, this is a song that I wrote with my dear friend Maggie Batts, where we did a lot of the same thing. She's like, I wanted to write a song with you, but you just ended up writing down what I was talking instead of she was trying to figure out the words and the lyrics. I basically took all of her own words and I said, that's neat, you wrote a song. And she's like, what the fuck? I did not write a song. And I was like, yeah, you did. Here it is.
Love that.
What's up, Jim Dimmick? How you doing, Jen? Welcome to On the Rise, my friends. We got something cool today. Enjoy the creation. Southbound on a good buzz, and I turned and I left just because it didn't feel right. So I cut all my strings and I sold all my things. I lost my mind all in due time. And that's when I felt abandoned and I sang my lullaby. And I covered my confessions, cut off all my ties. And if late could be the answer, then let me win this game. And if hate became a cancer, let me love your name. Let me love your name. Let me love your name. We used to stand up tall and we all had our time to crawl. Now it's just my turn to hold a light. shine it on you all with your back against a wall. We used to think that I was so bright, but I was blind. And that's when I felt abandoned, and I sang my lullabies, and I covered my confessions. I cut off all my ties, and if late could be the answer, then let me win this game. And if hate became a cancer, let me love your name. 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 Felt abandoned, and I sang my lullabies, and I covered my confessions. I cut off all my ties, and if late could be the answer, then let me win this game. And if hate became a cancer, let me love your name. 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 Sometimes I use, but most times you know. This could take forever, it's a long-winded show. Sometimes I use, but most times you know. All right, my friends, right there. That right there is that's Marigold, my friends. Make sure it's Jen says you're doing good. Doing good. Good stuff. Let me love your name, Lauren. Let me love your name. Yeah, that's Marigold by Maggie Batson and myself there. We put that one together. Thank you guys so much for hanging out. If you haven't hit the share button yet, why not? If you haven't hit the like and love, why not? Come on now. Get on it. We got James Martin hanging out. This is James M. Martin, if you want to look him up right here on Facebook. Thanks for all of our friends hanging out over there on the YouTube worlds. Let's see, this next song, now this is going to go out here now. If you tell us how you're feeling today. David Yule is coming in from Scotland right now, okay? James, and he says, sending love and hugs and positive and healing vibes to everyone all around the world, all the way from Aberdeen, Scotland. Sending it that way because global is the new local. And we all know this right here on The Rise.
Right.
All right. This next song, this is going to be the worst day. And I'm going to ask my man Keenan to, chime in on all that if he can there. If he's prepared. You ready?
I'm with you.
This also goes out to Josh Venice because I know this is one of his favorites. And if, for God's sakes, where's Steve Gunning? He seems to be working his ass off. And this is one of his favorite songs. And he needs to stop working so hard and start hanging out with his friends a little bit more. That's what I say. And this is The Worst. Tomorrow, so I guess that it should be okay to wallow in the sorrow and just smile, clown. Don't you know you're in a parade? Sing songs about the stars and scars, yeah, and poison in my veins. No, I am not my worst day. No, I am not what happened to me. Have you ever drifted off and not to sleep? I am not my worst day. No, I am not what happened to me. Have you ever drifted? And not to sleep. drifted off and not to sleep. I am not my worst day. No, I am not. What happened to me? Have you ever drifted off and not to sleep? The worst day, that was one of them that I put together. I'm not going to disclose who that friend was about or what necessarily. That's their own personal business and sort of things right there. It was kind of a during a personal therapy session with a good friend of mine, and he was struggling with his with trying to figure out what in the heck had happened and trying to figure out what's going to be his best coping mechanisms with some tough stuff in life. And we came up and realized that hey man, you're not your worst. You gotta stop beating yourself up on that worst moment in your life, and you gotta realize that's a small moment in a great big life. Don't do it. Billie Jean Garber, what's up, girl? How are you doing? We're coming to Peru on Friday. I'm excited about that. This song right here is another one that I wrote with a good friend, Maggie Batts. This goes out to Jay Davison. We call it Normal. Yes, it's blue across the table as you bow out, you walked away. I see your eyes, they're moving and stable across the fire, you found a flame. And that's normal, right? Please say I'm okay. I think I lost a friend today. And that's normal, right? Please say I'm okay. I lost a friend today. In my mind, we're at the funeral where you're alive and you're okay. And in my mind, I need your approval. Do I make you proud? Now who's to say, that that's normal, right? Please say I'm okay. I think I lost a friend today. That's normal, right? Please say I'm okay. I think I lost a friend today. And that's normal, right? Please say I'm okay. I think I lost a friend today. That's normal, right? Please say I'm okay. I lost a friend today. When I'm alone, I'm in your corner, and you're not here. I'm still here. I'm still here. And that's normal, right? Please say I'm okay. I think I lost a friend today. That's normal, right? Please say I'm okay. I think I lost a friend today. That's normal, right? Please say I'm okay. I think I lost a friend today. That's normal, right? Please say I'm okay. I lost a friend today.
That's beautiful.
Oh, thank you very much, James. Thank you very much. That song's called Normal. We wrote that with my dear friend Maggie Bass. She's a great songwriter. We did it the same way. It was kind of got a funny story. We were drinking late in the evenings after hanging out with our family and stuff. Megan fell asleep, went to bed. Vicky Gerber, what's up? How you doing, Vicky? Nice to see you. Kenny Shoot coming in. How are you doing, Kenny? Daniel, Jimmy, good afternoon to you too, sir. Amber Lynn Hurley with 500 stars says, take my stars. Thank you very much. Eric Cockenberry, nice to see you too. Dan Collins coming in. We got Boston. Well, we've got Indiana. We've got Ohio. Where are you guys all coming in from? DJ Romano chilling out right now from New Hampshire doing his thing. Let us know where you're coming in so we can share it with our friend James here. He's painting to the music today and painting to the vibe that's going on. Thank you very much, Dan Collins. That song will be available pretty soon because that's going to be on the nearest and dearest thing that we're putting together here too. So you guys are going to catch some really good stuff coming your way there. Let's see. And then we have... James is coming along pretty good there. James coming along pretty good, looking nice and purdy over there, looking nice, nice and good. It's got a cool thing going on over there, my buddy. Nice thing going on over there. Now James, when he came in here today, he now I am honored that you thought that I wrote Soul Shine. And I did look it up. It's an Allman Brothers song written by Warren Haynes. So this is Soul Shine, one of my favorite covers. I do my own version of it, and I hope that you appreciate it, Keenan, since you're over there being such a jerk with your mouth all the time on this show. Lauren Reeves, that's a beautiful painting, she says right there. It's a beautiful painting. Let's see, is there Russ Baum bears? Is there such merch, Jay Acting? No, I would like to. Never thought about having my own teddy bear.
Well, it would like, go great with the
Baum
puffy,
bears.
The puffy music.
It would.
Super Serial Tour.
It would. It really would. I wish I would have thought about that before right now. Build a Baum bear. Wait.
Ooh.
That sounds dangerous.
Build a Baum.
We probably shouldn't. These are things that get us shut down just saying out loud. How's it going out there? Bethany Cummins, nice to see you. She's Camp Explorer Brown County. She's out there doing that thing. We're going to send you out that Soul Shine wire. Dear friend James over here works on his artwork. When you can't find a light to guide you through the cloudy day, stars ain't shining bright, you feel like you've lost your way. Now when the candlelight from your home burns so very far away, you got to let your soul shine, just like my daddy used to say. He said soul shine, it's better than the sunshine, it's better than the moonshine, it's damn sure better than the rain. So people don't mind, we all feel this way sometimes. You gotta let your soul shine, shine till the break of day. I grew up thinking that I had it made, I can make it on my own. Life can take the strongest man and make him feel so alone. Now and then I feel a cold wind blowing through my aching bones. I think back to what my dad says. He said, boy, it's the darkest before the dawn. You got your soul shine, it's better than the sunshine, it's better than the moonshine, it's damn sure better than the rain. So people don't mind, but we all feel this way sometimes. You gotta lay your soul shine, shine to you the break of day. Take it there, King. Sometimes a man can feel his emptiness. It's like a woman rob him of his very soul. But a woman too, God knows, she can feel like this. And when your world turns cold, you gotta let your spirit take control. With that soul shine, it's better than the sunshine, better than the moonshine, it's damn sure better than the rain. Now people don't mind, but we all feel this way sometimes. You gotta lay your soul shine, shine till the break of day. Now lay your soul shine, shine till the break of day. You lay your soul shine, shine till the break of day. What's up, Monkey? How you doing, my dude? Monkey 87 hanging out in there. Morgan Garrett jumping in here. So nice to see you. So nice to see you. Oh, God. Yeah. Thank you very much there, Keenan. Thank you very much. Now, you know what's so funny is I forgot that, because they were like, yeah, the sugar bear. And I was like, oh, yeah, I get it now. I'd forgotten that I had been turned into a bear for this entire tour coming up.
A lot of great ideas coming through on this from the crowd here. One of them I saw was, it says, Karen Lee, she's listening from Seymour, Indiana, home of John Mellencamp. She'd rather be listening to Russ Baum. Well, I'd like to take that a step further and say, we should just invite John in here to do some painting, too.
You know, you're right.
John. I know he's he loves to paint.
Yeah, he does. Yeah, he does. You know what's kind of funny? I sent out a message to see about coming here. And it got a very quick He does not do those things.
Well, says, I think that if that you were talking to him about playing music, that would be a different thing than pursuing his passion, which is now painting.
Yes, you are. Right. I'm sure
can
you
can we
were.
Get John Mellencamp to start live painting? Like, going to concerts, and instead of playing, he paints?
Be awesome.
Here's the deal.
Can we do that?
I'm going to do something right in here. We're going to see. We are taking opportunity right now. Yes. All right? I'm going to tag my friend Tim in here.
Do
Tim
it.
Tim Elsner.
Uh-huh.
If it'll let me.
And from what I understand, Tim has been
Tim
John's
is a friend of mine, and he's one of John's
business associates.
Yes, and he is he would be the guy. He'd be like, "Please don't do this, Russ. Please don't tag me in this." Lucky for you, Tim has not let me do it on this iPad. I'm not giving up yet, though. I'm not giving up.
Yeah, you can always tag him in. We to are watch still later.
I feel like.
Well, it's looking beautiful there.
I feel like we're going to go for it. You just go ahead and you enjoy that beautiful painting that we got going on there. We're going to see if I can get Tim tagged in here and just to be like, look, we paint on the show, Tim. Sort of thing.
But, tell John to tune in.
You never
great dynamics in that painting right there.
Oh, isn't looking fantastic. It's a beautiful, beautiful thing. But all I got to do is get in here and it's
get in
it's
there,
gonna,
Russ.
It's going to happen. All right. I know this might be the slowest part of
good
that
thing
we've
got something really entertaining going on called live painting.
Live
you're
painting
sure
with James
letting me
Martin.
Down, Russ.
You know what, Kenan? You could do your job over there and. Well, I guess you are doing your job.
Oh, my job is mostly harassing you, right?
Yeah, so it totally works. Totally
what do you
works.
Think, James?
I'm going to try
I
this
was just
again.
Gonna, I wanted to add that the live painting, what I've heard recently, and I thought this was really cool, Alicia from Indica, she told me that one thing she noticed or she had this realization that not only is it cool to have a live painter at her shows because it's something else for people to watch, but the people who are hearing impaired are able to actually enjoy the show more because they can actually watch me paint, and I am painting with the music, so it gives them something to match up with the beat that they can feel.
Beautiful.
And I was like, that's pretty cool. I hadn't thought about that.
Oh, yeah, hey,
I've got him.
That's a great idea. Laura Bowden also has a great idea. She says, I know John's personal assistant. Maybe we should just get Russ back to doing what he does best, playing songs and picking on me and hand this off.
Yeah, maybe we couldn't.
Laura, feel free to hand this off or take this up for us.
Yeah.
Eric Cockerberry says John can't deny painting while Sugar Bear sings.
There you go.
Sing, Sugar Bear. Sing.
Tim's gonna be like, that's the weirdest message ever. It just says, hey buddy, we're doing some live painting today. Miss you, bud. He's gonna be like, really? I'm sure this has nothing to do with any sort of ulterior motive, Russ. I'm sure he doesn't. No, I love Tim, but it'd be great if he stops in here. If I see him drop in, I gotta say hi to him.
Amber says, if we buy
Thanks,
that
Laura.
Art, can we meet the artist? What do you
Ooh.
Say to that, James?
Yes.
That
you
sounds
meet,
like a yes.
Come to Indie Walls. I've got a lot more art. It's in Indianapolis. Yeah. Look it up. Come see it. I got plenty of paintings you can buy.
You know, here's the one of the neat things. Now, I may not have my high notes today, but I'm going to give it my best. The next
we
song.
Howl?
Take a. We should howl, but this is similar to the howl. It's actually, I think, a little higher than the howl. We'll see. We probably won't have it. But this next song is called The Wave. As James happens to be painting waves.
How about that? It's intuition, buddy.
I wrote this with my buddy Don Schaefer. He's living in Seattle, Washington these days, and I've been threatening to come and see him for years since he's moved out there and haven't got a chance to see his face in good probably 6 years or more. Good reason to go out there and see Zach Weback Vaughn and all of our friends Jenny Brown up in that area. But we wrote this song one day, we were sitting down. I was 32 years old, and I think, I want to say that he was turning 38. It's a wave, it's a fire within. Take to the grave, am I prepared for this? This night is long, but the night is dim. Melt your ignorance. This 38 is flying by so quick. But it's a wave. It's a wave. It's a wave. But it's a wave. It's falling down, it's breaking out. The feeling's gone, the light is out. We're going under now, I don't know what to do. Too. I feel nice. That's the wave, my friends, right there. That's a we've only played that song a couple times on the Jason Markle coming in with the waves. What's up?
Look,
hey there,
I'd
pirate.
I'd hate to be presumptuous, but before you got here, Russ, James and I were chatting about life being like catching a series of waves. Mm-hmm. You have to not be afraid to jump from one wave to the next and catch the next one, because it's not all about each individual wave.
Yes.
And then it looks like we're painting a painting that involves waves, and you're singing this song at me for the first time. I've never heard this song.
You're right.
I'm not trying to name anybody's art, but it sounds like a
the wave.
The wave.
We're all on that same frequency wave, right?
That's what happens when you use your intuition to create art. You end up creating art that people's like, hey, wait, how could you have worked? How did you know?
How did you know?
We can't know. When you use your intuition, it tells you.
Right. You told me, right? That's the same thing I do whenever I'm talking about that songwriting thing. When I'm writing with other people, they're like, I didn't write that. And they're like, yes, you did. You told it to me.
Yeah,
like, but that's what I wanted to say. And I was like, because you said it. And they're like, but I didn't actually say it. It's weird. You know, what do you do? Thor and Michael, welcome to the show. Let's see. Dan Collins says, great. He's liking it. Now, how about this? How about this artwork coming together right there? Our friend James Martin. Now, James is into so many amazing things, too. So I'm going to interrupt him just a little bit before we move on to the next song. Now he says that he can take chat, and at the same time, he can paint.
Sure.
So he's a lot like this guy where I'm talking to my friends and playing music kind of at the same time. So why don't you tell us a little bit, another thing now. Now, James is involved in many wonderful things, and he's created an entire life of art and helping other things. Mystical moments, Jay Acton says. I agree. Let's see. We also have Kelly Weitzel hanging out. How you doing there? Let's see. We've got, tell us a little bit about, what is the Beach Grove Artist Collective?
Yeah. So this was a few years ago, before I closed, or I've ever shown any art publicly. I was an artist that would do commissions, and I had done 6 years or 4 or 5 years of paint parties, but I had never actually shown my art and was like, hey, come buy my art. I just felt like that was very egotistical, and so I was trying to avoid that. And I met these artists that came to this event that I was at in Beach Grove, the Going Green in the Grove, and two of these artists, Sam Posthumus and Cherie Joy, both from Beach Grove, they came to me and said, hey, we had done this first Friday once. There's like four of us, and we're trying to get more artists to join us so we can bring Beach Grove back to life, because it was a
nice
dead town. And I went there. Most of my paintings I sell, and then I paint another one, and then I sell it, and then I paint it. So I don't have any paintings. I was like, but I do have a box of like 100 or 200 of these paint party paintings that I've done. I was like, but they're junk. I was paying attention to the class. I didn't really pay attention to the painting. And they said, oh, just bring them and sell them for $5 if you want. But just come and be a part of the group. So I came and I sat up my box of stuff, and I really just got to meet people and networking, and that grew like exponentially. We could not believe how quickly we set up Beach Grove Artist Collective. We decided then we're going to start doing events for artists, and then people started showing up. Not just the artists showing up to sell their art, but people came out of the woodworks in Beach Grove, and all
art
of a sudden,
supporters.
Small businesses started to open up on Main Street, and then the mayor came to and was like, "Hey, you guys are making a difference in this town. You're bringing it back to life." And then we ended up having over 100 artists on Main Street selling their stuff.
Amazing.
And a year before that, those people, you know, hadn't even been creating. They were like, well, yeah, we came out here and realized we could do this. And so we're at the point to where we are as a group, we're probably at our capacity of us being able to get together and create our art, but also come together and create events and organize stuff. And we're getting ready to kick off. I guess we've kicked off First Friday. We had our first Friday of the year this past First Friday, and every first Friday of the month, come on out to Main Street, Beach Grove, to see all of the different artists. And then after that's over, head over to Indy Walls and see everyone kind of meanders from Beach Grove Main Street over to Indy Walls afterwards, where there's a big art celebration going on every Friday and Saturday night.
That's fantastic. It sounds like a fantastic thing to get involved in. You're going to be seeing me around there. So anybody up there's in that Indianapolis area, or if you come through Indianapolis for any reason, check it out. I'm sure you'll be happy. Now, Indianapolis, the Beach Grove is very close to Indianapolis. So people are saying it helps put us in central Indiana. It's actually part of Indianapolis?
Inside of Indianapolis. It's its own little city inside of a city.
City in a city.
Yeah.
That's kind of neat. It's almost like a, I don't know.
It's like Speedway. Speedway is the same way.
It's like a restaurant inside of a gas station.
Yeah, I guess pretty much.
I guess like the Speedway gas stations.
A little classier than that. But it's a
Wawa.
That's my classy.
That's a Wawa.
Russ.
You know, you're talking about a Wawa. So we're not talking about Speedways. Speedways. Do not trust the churros or the anything rolling on a cooker at a Speedway gas station.
Just say no.
You know those things.
Unless it's after midnight, Lisa, and then that doesn't count anymore.
then it's already crawled off the thing. It's got its own life. Let it live. Let it live. It's still alive. I don't know. That's horrible. But this has led to this next song. In no way, no correlation. This is the worst transition I've ever had. So the next song is called "On the Rise." You know, we named the show "On the Rise." I say we because it wasn't me; it was all you guys out there. As we started this thing in our long history that we've had together, "On the Rise." Lisa Chappell, welcome to the show. Thanks for hanging out. Nice to see you. And Lisa Maurice hanging out. She's Lisa Melo over there on YouTube. How you doing, Lisa? Sending out that buffalo love. We appreciate you guys out there. But the fans, we took a vote about a year and a half or so ago. Once we realized this was actually a thing, it wasn't just a guy sitting and playing hoping to survive. Oh my goodness, all that coughing going on. See, Laura and Tina, don't you both already participate in First Fridays at Beach Grove? She says, I need to take my arts and wares there too. Yeah, Lorden, you know what's going on. She knows what's going on.
BeachGroveArtistCollective.com.
BeachGroveArtistCollective.com. Now, everything that we've discussed with James, there are links right here in the description of the video, guys, so you can check out exactly what it is. You don't have to remember. You don't have to worry about that. But this is a co-write with Clint Zimmerman and Mr. Clayton Rushton. All right, and we were hanging out. I was living out in Gosport, Indiana, and it was the same sort of collective works that created this song, "On the Rise," and I'm happy you guys picked this song. I'm glad we didn't name it "End of the Line," because then it would have been like, it's over. So, sort of thing.
This is it.
What you got? I got a funny face coming over here.
I thought you only normally capoed this on one, but you capo on two.
So. Yeah, I'm on
just
two.
Just taking notes.
All right, guys. So this right here is "On the Rise." First time here, Lisa. Well, thank you so much for chilling out. Here's some of the music we do. Stacy Spirit is also in the house. Nice to see you, Stacy. Hope life is treating you right. Gosport, there's a star in the sky. Well, thank you, Dan. And there's red in our eyes, and the light is pure. It had us paralyzed, hypnotized. And I sold my soul to a love unknown. I'm believing in my mind. And it burns like coal as it chills my bones. Welcome all you new folks, we appreciate you here. Well, the pace is slow, it's right on course to taking flight. We hang our faces low, and our hands are torn from just getting by. And I sold my soul to a love unknown. I'm believing in my mind. Burns like coal as it chills my bones. Now I'm on the rise. 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 On my friends. If we help you accomplish that goal, please just send a little bit of love in those comments. Share this with some friends. We got James, Maurice, Martin hanging out, painting to the tunes. Dream with me out over the oceans and go subconsciously into our emotions. And I know the songs that we sing will come to us as long as we bring all that we need. Now you are all that I need. So easy, just like the sun and the moon. You come and go so freely. I know it's nothing to you, but to me it's so dreamy. It's the way that you move. The way that you move. Thank you, Stacy. The stars, well, they may hold the sands of time, but this moment is ours, and we must keep it locked inside of both of our hearts, so it could never fade away. We're off of the charts, and in our dreams we will. So dreamy, it's the way that you move. You make it look so easy. You're like the sun and the moon. You come and go so freely. I know it's nothing to you, but to me it's so dreamy. The way that you move. All right, that one right there was a song called Dreamy out of On the Rise. I just decided to go with it there, Keenan. Just decided to go with it. I don't think I've ever actually just done that song at the end of that. I think just we always start it, and then I'm just like set it down. But we did it, guys. We did it. Happy Danged Old Wednesday to you. Are you having a good day? All of our new friends, we appreciate you hanging out. We do this thing every single Monday through Friday-ish, depending on if I'm on tour or not, or if I'm coming home from a hard day's work out there singing and yelling with my friends. Maggie Batts just now showing up. What's up, Mags? How you doing? We sing our songs. We did both of them, girl. Nice to see you coming in here so you can get a little bit of that love. Susan Stinnett, she's up in it. How you doing? She says, the sun's shining out there. She's shining out there. We love you, girl. I hope everything's going well out there. I see Jeremy Jack showed up. It's been a while, my dude. Nice to see you. Now that,
hello, Maggie Betts.
Hope you're not working too hard. In case you didn't know, Keenan wanted to say hi, Maggie.
I was very subtle about that, wasn't I? Hi, Maggie.
Yeah. What's up, Mags? Laura Bowden, check this out. Thank you so much for the compliment. She says, I hope you guys all realize just how amazing this show is. I grew up in Corvallis, Oregon, and grew up the daughter of a hippie musician who hung out at the Beanery, where they played music all the time. Basically, an in-person show just like this. Just a normal thing. I love and miss that so much. Oh, hell yeah. Bringing back those good memories. Thank you very much. 500 stars. Thank you so much, Lisa Chappell. She just sent us in there. She says, please support these amazing artists who have helped us around the globe. We appreciate you right there, Lisa Chappell. That is a great comment. We'll let me open it completely up there. Greg Monday, nice to see you. And, you know, that's what we say. Global is the new local, and we know it right here on the rise, my friends. And I want to say thank you very much. And now, Keenan, I think it would be wrong to have a guy like James in here And James Markle says, have we done 1910? We have not. Now, we probably extended our show. It's been a longer show than we normally do, I think.
That's quite all right.
Is that all right with you there, Keenan?
I'm fine.
How about you, James? Do you want to get over there?
Oh, absolutely.
Aw, Jay Acton called me Rusty Bear. That made me feel good there. So we'll do 1910, and then maybe we can get a little sunning from Keenan.
Yeah, I'd play some sunning.
If you don't mind there, Keener.
Don't mind the wiener. I do. Yeah.
The carpet cleaner. That's right, James. Now this one right here, we're gonna go ahead and give it to you there, since you want to hear it, James Markle. Marcus Prestige is in the house. This is 1910. Lisa says, "Don't call me Melo. It's mellow like yellow." Love you, okay. Love you, Lisa. Lisa Melo, love you, girl. Bye. All right, but this right here is Wednesday starts the weekend, Keenan.
Do it.
For a minute, tell a true story of a 22-year-old Russ Baum. Well, it's a different day, I bought the same old thing again. And I roll off with a couch, and it's time for me to begin. Well, I go to the fridge, and we're out of beer, my friend. So I slap on my shoes, then I head on down the block. Store's gonna be my first stop. Oh, and they know what I want before I walk in. I said a case of Bud Light will be 1910, my friend. Well, I stroll down the road and I see a friend of mine. I was like, what's up, James? Well, he's got some weed, man. It's always a real good time. I said, hey, James, listen right here. If you get me high, you could help me drink my beer. And now we're drunk and we're high and we don't know what's going on. Well, I reach in my case, but a hole of my beer is gone. So I slap on my shoes because I know what to do. I gotta get to a liquor store real soon. And I know what I want before I walk in. I said a case of Bud Light will be 1910, my friend. We got a real-life pirate in the house, James Markle. He's smiling from ear to ear. How you doing, James? Albino Morello, welcome to the show. Ciao. Well, I stroll back home, yeah, and all of my friends are there. Yeah, they say where you've been. We've been waiting for you here. To listen right here, if you get me high, you could help me drink my beer. So now we're drunk and we're high and we don't know what's going on. What is going on? Well, I reach in my case, but all of my beer is gone. So I slap on my shoes cause I know what to do. Gotta get to a liquor store real soon. And I know what I want before I walk in. Bud Light will be 1910, my friend. What up, Jesse Rules? She says, good morning out here in California. Oh, yeah. Well, I stroll back home and looking for the party. And I search all around, but I can't find it. Alone, and I sit on a couch till I pass out. It's a different day, but the same old thing. When I roll over the couch, it's time to drink again. All right, Keenan, I got an idea. I'm gonna play a little bit of a mood music while you get on over here. Maybe if you show the painting going on, maybe, you know, something like that, maybe. Show him a little bit of that James Martin painting action while I'm playing some inspirating music for you to come over here. And just like yesterday, you could grab another guitar, make it all work. Flawless.
Got ideas.
No. month of May. But I bet you'd say, what could make me feel this way? It's my girl. Talking about my girl. I got so much honey. The bees envy me. And I got more songs than the birds in the trees. But I bet you'd say, what can make me feel this way? It's my girl. Talking about my girl. She's got a whole lot of reasons. She just can't think of a single one to justify leaving. And he got none, but he thinks he got so many problems. What he's got is too much time to waste. His dreams are like commercials, but her dreams are picture perfect. And the dreams are so related, though they're often underestimated. Simple as something that nobody knows. And her eyes are as big as her bubbly toes. On the feet of a queen of a heart to be cause. Feet are infested with tar ball. And she la ta 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 ta. La ta 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 ta. La ta 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 ta. La ta 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 ta. Down at the DLG when this little girl came and she sat next to me. Never seen nobody move the way she did, but she did, oh, she does now, she'll do it again. When you move like a jellyfish, rhythm is nothing, you go with that flow, you don't stop. So move like a jellyfish, rhythm is nothing, you go with the flow, you don't stop.
My song in the key of C. I play it out of G. You can do whatever you want, but bless your heart.
Oh, thank you, Russ.
That's beautiful.
Well, keep this job, man. Keep your money. Ain't got nothing against anybody's ever wasting my time. Just cause I'm broke, it don't mean I'm running. I'm like a frog on a rock just a sunning. Waiting on a meal to pass by. Job, man, keep your money. Ain't got nothing against anybody's ever wasting my time. I might be useless as tits on a hog and funny looking like a three-legged dog, but I'm getting my. Yeah, I like living right and being free. It's all anyone can say for me. So keep this job, man, keep your money. Ain't got nothing against anybody's ever wasting my time. Well, I've been young, I've had trouble. Bad mistakes I made double, but God's on my side. Yeah, I like living right and being free. It's all anyone can say for me. Man, keep your money. Ain't got nothing against anybody's ever wasting my time. Just cause I'm scared, it don't mean I'm running. I'm like a frog on a rock, just a sunning, waiting on a meal to pass by. I like living right and being free. Give a damn what to say about me. So keep this job, man, keep your money. Ain't got nothing against anybody's ever wasting my time.
That worked. Yeah. Two red lights are on?
Yeah, red lights were on. I was worried I muted you completely.
That's all right. I love it when you get a little little piece of my world over there, Russ.
Yeah, you know, I'll take another little piece of your world
right
now.
Take another little piece of my world now, Russ.
Yeah, and because, you know, I hope that you enjoy your world, Keener, the wiener.
I do. I do.
And I hope you realize that... we are officially, it's now time for you to make things awkward.
It's got to get awkward in here, doesn't it? Goodbye.
I would like you to take a look at this piece of art, and if you could, just make fun of it, Keenan.
Oh, no. Like, that sounds terrible.
Yeah, please hurt James' feelings. He promised he would talk a lot today,
James,
and he didn't.
I really just don't understand why you put that god-awful font on that piece of artwork there. On the Rise? Well, that's a terrible name. Terrible name.
The feeling that I had was...
It's not even on kilter, dude. It's like...
Whatever.
Diagonal to the waves. If you're going to write something on there, you should have wrote The Wave and titled it really tastefully down in the bottom corner.
You're right.
Something.
I don't know what I was thinking.
Look at that.
Can you explain to me what was going through your head? What were you thinking when you thought, let me put that big, tacky bunch of
writing? Actually, half the painting, I was thinking, well, tomorrow at the grocery store, I'm going to need to pick up some more bread and some milk.
Bread and milk is on your mind.
We can make it really ugly now.
Oh, my goodness. Don't do it, Russ.
Do you like...
Oh, my goodness. Don't do it, Russ. Oh, it's going to get so awkward.
Sorry, James, that Keenan's such a jerk.
Look at that. Man, that's beautiful font. James, you're a genius. Look what you did there.
You know what genius rhymes with?
And that tagline there, music by the people. Maybe we should add art by the people.
Visual art by the James. The crap that we put on the screen.
Amazing.
Music is art. Just
amazing. Art represents music as well.
Like, you know.
I think we should just start saying like, art festivals.
Oh, Russ.
I feel like I've got better plans.
I think Russ is finger painting over there.
Hey, that's fun. That's finger paint, guys.
Look at him go. Saying, right on top of your beautiful canvas. He's just finger painting away.
That's it. Russell. Thanks for hanging out, guys.
Look at that.
Bless you.
That's pretty.
That's awkward.
That's way better. I like
it's
that.
It's been a pleasure, ladies
I don't know
and
how
gentlemen.
To make that presents thing just disappear.
Oh, probably you just hit that clear over there on the far left. Oh, just that layer, and then press go, and it'll go away.
I probably just deleted it.
Send it away. There we go. Ladies and gentlemen, this has been On the Rise with none other than Mr. Russ Baum, with special guest James Martin right here in Rainwater Studios. Thank you so much for tuning in. It's been a pleasure making music and art for you today, and we just so much enjoy your company. Thank you for your support. We'll be back maybe not tomorrow morning. Oh, this is getting awkward. Russ, I have a staff meeting tomorrow. What are we going to do? Do you want to do it later in the
afternoon?
No. A staff meeting in the morning at 10:30. So if you want to get together, it's going to have to be later in the day, but I just don't think we're going to do it tomorrow.
Well, I don't think we're going to do it tomorrow. Luckily, I don't need you to pursue my dreams, and I can do the show from the basement of our house where this all started.
When did you get so independent,
Russ? Since you started deciding that staff meetings are more important than donating your time for free.
Ladies and gentlemen, back to this wonderful goodbye we were saying. This is all about you, ladies and gentlemen, and us telling you that we'll be back someday. It might be
tomorrow.
It might be
Friday. I'll be back tomorrow.
Russ will be back tomorrow.